children, hope you all are doing good. So this class we are going to start. We are going to continue lesson number 1, rock, mineral and soil. So last class I have given introduction about rocks. Okay, also I have explained what are the types of rocks and what is the uses of those types of rocks. Also I explained 2 types of minerals, petroleum and gemstones. Also I have given small introduction about soil. Okay, so this class I am going to continue with the soil. How the soil it will form? It is a breakdown of rocks and minerals. The soil it will form, the breakdown of rocks and minerals. The formation of soil takes place over a long period of time. More than 1000 years it will take to form a soil. Okay. It can be take thousands of years, even more. Soil it is formed by breaking down of rocks and minerals. Next. How the soil is formed? See, for example, whenever the heavy rain it will be there, the rain it will be hitting on the rocks. So what will happen? Due to that force, it will make a small cracks. Also, this rocks it will be wet. When the sun shines, okay, the rocks it will get heat up very fast. Okay, once it will get heat up, what it will do? It will make a cracks. Okay, again the continuous rain and continuous heat, this rocks it will leave. Make more cracks. Due to that cracks, the soil it will form. Also, you can able to see the few plants it will be growing in between the rock, right? So because of the water it is present inside the rock, so that is the reason the plants can also able to grow inside the rock. This roots what it will do? So wherever this minute gap it will be there on the rocks, right? There it will penetrate their roots. So this roots also it will make major cracks in the rocks. So also whenever the rainy season, the water it will be present inside the rock. Wherever the gap is there, wherever the crack is happened, so there the water it will go and accumulate. Once the water it will get freeze inside the rock, even that also it will leads to major cracks of the rocks. So like this different types of the way the soil it will form. Okay, even you can able to see the wherever the this faults and all will be there, no? So there also from the major big rock, because continuously water flow will be there. Whenever it will hit the rock with the water, the minute small amount of soil it will form over there. So that is the reason from the rock to form a soil it will take more than 1000 years. Okay, it is not an easy process. Okay, and next one we are going to see layers of the soil. So how many layers of the soil we have? We have 3 different layers of the soil. The first layer is called as a top layer or top soil, and second it is called as a subsoil, and third one it is called as a bedrock. Here you can able to see in the images. Here this part of the soil it is called as a top soil. It is more fertile soil. Okay, and here you can able to see the rock will be here and there. You can able to find out rocks. So that is called as a subsoil. And next down part it is called as a bedrock. At the lower surface of the soil, we can able to find out many types of rocks like this. It will form as a bed. Okay, so that is the reason it is called as a bedrock. Okay, the first one I am going to explain, the top layer or top soil. So it is 4 inches thick and dark in color. See, whatever the top layer of the soil we can able to see, it will be like in a 4 inches. Okay, 4 inches. Also it will be very dark in color. Okay, if it is a black soil it is very black in color. If it is in a brown soil or red soil, it will be dark red in color. Okay, so like that it will be having a very dark in color. This soil it is very fertile. It is rich in nutrients. Whatever it is, the nitrogen amount more it is present in the top layer of the soil. So this nitrogen it will be helpful for the plant growth and development. Okay, this is very rich in fertility since it has loam and humus, remains the plants and animals. So here only the plants and animals having any amount of nitrogen here, only the soil will be present here. This is a layer below, top soil and slightly grey and red in color. Okay, this layer of soil is slightly red and grey in color. Next, they have too many stones also. They have too many stones inside the soil, and this layer has little food for plants. So here you can see, here more amount of nitrogen will be present in the soil. Here there is, it is not fertile soil, only less amount of nutrient it will get. Okay, less amount of minerals will be present. Okay, from here also the plant needs of the minerals. Okay, and next one, subsoil is hard and not porous. So here it is a top layer, it is a soft and porous, right? But here the soil is very tightly held and it is compactly packed. Okay, it is very hard. Okay, and even the air also it is not able to pass because it is non-porous soil. And next one we are going to see, bedrock. What is mean by bedrock? Next, subsoil below that, whatever the rocks it is present, it is called as a bedrocks. See, the bedrocks, it is a bottommost layer. This is a bottommost layer. It mostly consists of pebbles and broken rock. So it is having a more pebbles. Pebbles will be present, like small small rocks will be there, and the large amount of rocks also will be there. And it has more humus. Humus means we can't able to find out the soil over there. Okay, and it holds a little water. Also here, if it is a soil, is it will hold the water. If soil is not there here, then it won't hold the water. Only little amount of water can able to hold. Hence, the roots usually do not reach this layer. See, this plant root only it will reach to top layer and sub layer. It won't reach at the bottommost layer. Right. So here the nutrient is not there, even the soil humus is not there, and it is containing pebbles and small rocks and the big rocks. So this layer is called as a bedrock. And next one we are going to see, soil erosion. What does mean by soil erosion? See, the erosion means wearing off or carrying away the soil. The wearing off and carrying away of the soil. Okay. See, whenever the rainfall will be there, heavy rainfall will be there. Okay. In roadside also we can able to see, the soil it won't be there. The sand it won't be there. Through that water forces, it will take all sand and soil, whatever it is present, even dust and waste particle, whatever it is there on the road, that also it will carry away and it will flow by water. Okay. So likewise, it will be happen in a normal forest area or normal farming land. So this kind of soil erosion it will happen. Okay. So this soil erosion is happened by natural forces of wind and water. It will happen by natural forces of wind and water. What is meant by soil erosion? Wearing off and carrying off. Carrying away of the soil. It is called as a, from one place to another place that soil it will move due to presence of wind and water. So this type it is called as a soil erosion. And there is two, this causes of soil erosion it will be happened by the two natural forces. One is water and one more is wind. Okay, so how, whenever the water, heavy rainfall will be there, along with the water, even the soil particle also it will move on the flowing of water. So like that the soil erosion will happen. And also, when the river side alone we can able to see, we can able to find only like a small pebbles kind. Then we can't able to find out the soil, because soil is very thin and light particle. Easily it can able to carry away from one place to another place through the help of water and wind. Okay, so due to the rain water and river water, whatever the soil is present in the area, it will wash away. Okay, it will wash away and it will go and reach from some other place. And next one, erosion by wind. Due to wind, heavy wind flow will be there. So that time also, whatever the fertile soil will be there on the top layer, because this soil is very soft and it is porous, right? So very wind flow it okay, because it is having more amount of minerals and nitrogen. It is very soft and porous in nature. Whenever the heavy wind it will come, so this soil it will flow away. Okay, so that time what will happen? Whatever the fertile soil will be there in the agriculture land, it will be fly away and will go and reach into some other place. So like this two ways the soil erosion will happen. Okay, and next one we are going to see conservation. How we can able to conservation? See, we can't able to stop rain and we can't able to stop wind to blow. So this all it is happened by the natural forces, right? We are not able to stop those things. So how we are going to save our soil? Okay, so following method we are going to save our soil. For example, we have to plant more trees. Okay, once we are planting more trees, what will do this roots? It will be held the soil very tightly. This roots it will hold the soil very tightly. It won't hollow for the soil erosion. Like grass or small plants, whatever it is, whatever the root it is present in the plant, it will hold the soil very tightly. It won't allow for the soil to get erode. Okay, and next one, making bunds and embankments. What is meant by bunds and embankments? In the river, in between they will construct the dam and all, right? Whenever the heavy rainfall will be there, in the river water also it will get increased. Okay, in the river water and the rain water, more amount of soil also it will come along with the water. So in between they will construct any dam in between the river. What will happen? The soil also it will stop over there, and the whatever the water it is, whatever water it is filled over there, the soil particle it will slowly it will settle down at the bottom of the layer. Then water it will move off. Okay, so like that way we can able to stop the soil to erode. And next one, making terrace and furrows. So what is meant by terrace? For example, the mountain areas they will be, you can able to see how they will do the forming. They will be doing a step-wise forming, right? You people have studied in social also this. So they will be doing a step-wise forming. So they will be doing step-wise forming. They will be doing like this. Have you people observed? Okay, they will be doing a step-wise forming whenever the heavy rain will be there. Okay, so that time whatever the soil it will get eroded here, so it will be settled down here. Then only water it will come down. Okay, again if in the water any soil is there, then it will settle down here. Then again only water it will come. So like this, the step forming if they will do, we can avoid the soil erosion completely. Okay, like this, in this three ways we can be able to control the soil erosion. So this is called as a conservation. Conservation, acting of the eroding agent cannot be stopped. We can't able to stop rainwater and we can't able to stop the wind to blow. Because of this reason, we have to take few steps to save the soil, to save from the erosion. Okay, the first one is planting trees and grass, and second one is making bunds and embankments, and third one is a terrace, making terrace or a furrows. So this it will be happen in the mountain areas. Okay, like this ways we can able to prevent the soil erosion. And what is meant by counter forming? Underline this children, it is very important. The method of forming to prevent the soil erosion. This is a forming, it is an agricultural land kind of here you can take in the mountains. Okay, this method of forming it will prevent the soil erosion. So this is called as a counter forming. So this is called as a counter forming to avoid the soil erosion by forming. Okay, so you have to underline that. That is very important. Okay, I will be asking in a 2-mark question. Next, we'll move on for our textbook exercise. Everyone, take your page number 156. Now we'll move on for B main. So that is fill in the blanks. The first question: the red fort is made up of. They are given option like marbles and sandstone. So the red fort is made up of sandstone. Put a tick mark next to sandstone and write in the line. And you have to fill in the blanks. You have to put a tick mark next to the sandstone and you have to write fill in the blanks as a sandstone. And second one, dash is used to make blackboard and roofing tiles. They are given options slate and pumice. So the answer you have to write here, slate. Answer the following questions. Okay, thank you children, have a nice day.